Welcome to another Tech Tuesday edition here at Leading Edge Equipment. Today I'd like to show you how to set up RowSense on this Gen 4 4600 display. For starters, before we get into that, we need to make sure our setup information is filled out. Up in the top left, our client farm and field. Below that, our equipment, our combine, and our header. And then making sure our crop type and our variety is filled out under work summary. The next place we'll go to is our menu button on the bottom right hand corner. Once in here, we'll select applications on the left hand side. Then we're looking for this auto track guidance icon. Once in here, we need to set up a guidance track before we get into the RowSense so we can make sure it's enabled. To do that, you just go into the set track and then create a guidance line. After that is complete, we need to go to this icon with the arrow up with a dot above it. You should see the RowSense Details box listed in the list of options. Once in here, we will select the RowSense to on. Once this is selected, you'll notice that there's two options below it, a GPS steer and a manual steer. The difference between these two is whenever we select GPS steer, pressing the auto header height button once will engage the guidance only with one press. The second press will engage the RowSense fillers. When pressing the manual steer, pressing it once will lower the header and will engage the guidance and RowSense fillers with the second press. After that is completed, on which one you want to select and use for your entry mode, we need to go into the RowSense status. Once in here, you'll see some different options on the left-hand side of this box. Our sensor offset, we can adjust that as we're going down the field. When going to the right, you'll notice it goes to a plus. When going to the left, you'll notice it goes to a negative. That is just simply its version of shifting right and left. When looking at the sensor voltages down on the bottom left-hand corner, we want the left sensor to be 2.5 or less, and we want our right sensor to be 2.5 or greater. If these are off by it for any reason, we can go into this calibrate and follow the steps that it suggests to do. Once the calibration is complete, we can jump back out here. We should see green check marks on the statuses going down on the right hand side. For this demonstration, it's just a simulator. It's just showing you that there's only three of the five options that are ready. The other thing I want to show you when getting out of this and going to your AutoTrack Guidance main page, you should see your RowSense status indicator on the bottom right here. When this is actually activated, there's four different colors that are going to show you on the page. If you see a gray color, it's in standby mode and it's not ready. If you see a green color, that means it is using both GPS and the RowSense feelers. If you see yellow, it's using the RowSense sensors only. And then orange is the GPS only.